And welcome back to the Fun Astrology Podcast, Thursday, September 26th. Thomas Miller back with you, and we are going to do this today. I'm not going to get distracted by anything in the chart. We're going to talk about Libra. Been promising it since Monday, and there were just other things that the business at hand. But most of the things that we've been talking about this week are still in effect one way or another. Those aspects with the moon are not, because the moon has moved into Virgo. But everything else is. So I'm just going to leave the energy of the chart alone for today, and let's talk about these Libran characteristics, because Libra is a very important sign. First of all, it is ruled by Venus. So remember, every sign has a planetary ruler. Venus does double duty because it rules Libra. It also rules Taurus. But we're going to shine the spotlight on Libra today because the characteristics of it are slightly different. First of all, Libra is an air sign, where Taurus is an earth sign. So Libra, not as grounded, more idea-based, out there in the world. You know, if you want, I've always said, if you want to hire the best employee in the world, and this does not go with EEOC regulations for those of you in HR, but if you wanted to hire the best person in the world, go find a Virgo. And that's not universally true, obviously, but I'm just saying Virgos are known as really good employees. If you want to find the person with the thickest Rolodex, now, if you don't know what a Rolodex is, that's something that you used to keep. Boy, there's a generational thing for you, right? It used to be on paper, and you would keep your names and phone numbers and addresses in there, and certainly not emails, because what was that? But if you wanted the thickest Rolodex of the astro circle, go find a Libra. Connected. That's that air connection. They are all about ideas, and they are all about just melting barriers between people. That's that Venus influence combined with Libra's air. Now, another thing that's kind of interesting, and I mentioned this, I believe, last week, is that in ancient astrology, if we go back to Hellenistic or what is traditional or ancient astrology, the sun was considered to be at detriment in Libra. Now, why? What do you mean by that? Well, what it basically means is that both the sign and the planet, or in this case the sun, are just not complementary in their characteristics, so they can't fully express themselves. The characteristics are somewhat muted. So if you think about the sun shining brightly, you think about Libra, you think of balance, and those two just, like, it's like I said, what is balanced about the sun? It's all fire all the time. And here Libra is pulling us back and saying, no, let's see both sides. And the sun says, I'm daytime only. I don't do night. And that's where they can wrestle with each other. Now, there's another way to form this up, though, because we can say the sun with its shining bright characteristics and Libra's balanced feminine energy smooths the sun's attributes. And that's one of the things that makes Libras so winsome and so attractive and so popular, is because people feel more comfortable. So see, there's two sides on astrology. The ancients believed it wasn't a good fit. Modern astrology, yeah, there's some balance there, and it takes a little bit of the edge off of the sun. Some other Venus characteristics we have to bring into the mix, obviously, romance and love and relationship, because Libra and Venus rule the seventh house of relationships and partnerships. So where we take that is that Libras are very comfortable in relationships and often very committed to them. Also, Libras can be very influential in putting business partnerships together, because the seventh house is not just about your preferred sex relationship, shall we say. It is also about partnerships, and that's any kind of partnership that you engage in. So marriage would certainly be under that category, but so would a business partnership. I worked with a Leo physician for a while. I've known him for over 10 years, and he was more successful in business than as a physician, and he was successful as a physician, but he was able to put the business side together, and he put partnerships together and sold companies for millions of dollars. Birthday, October 1, there's a Libra for you. Another characteristic is physical appearance. You know, Libras are usually pretty people. That's another characteristic of the Gemini rising sign as well, is there's just a youthfulness about Gemini rising. There's a pretty, beautiful handsomeness about Libras. You don't think that this stuff works? That's the Sun and Venus. That's the Sun-Venus combination. What are some of the dark sides? Because every sign and every planet has both sides, right? So let's take a look at the other side of Libra. For one is, I think that they can be kind of full of themselves. All that beauty is just, and this is so subconscious. I mean, this is just kind of what's baked into the system, is that subconsciously they know they have that love aspect. They know they have this winsomeness, and it comes sometimes across as arrogance or vanity. And sometimes that can come across also as being critical or nitpicky. Again, from that superiority paradigm, Libras do not like that conflict. They will try to be the peacemaker because they want the balance, and they can see both sides. But sometimes that can lead to either procrastination or just a lack of decision making. So there can be an indecision factor, just can't necessarily get things on track. And of course, all of those characteristics are complemented and accented and accentuated and offset by other planets, angles, aspects, signs, and everything in the chart. Now, as far as relationships, the opposite of Libra is Aries. So opposites sometimes attract, but often opposites can definitely repel. And the fire of Aries and the balance of Libra is kind of like what we were talking about with the Sun. Sometimes that might not be the best fit. Couple that are the other air signs, Gemini and Aquarius. Those air characteristics can complement Libra quite nicely. What would be tense? Well, Cancer and Capricorn. In fact, the water signs are maybe not quite as complementary with the air signs in general, but a Libra just doesn't know what to do with Capricorn's structure and cannot figure out Cancer's emotions. So that kind of gives you an idea on just a quick look at the relationship possibilities. All right, there is Libra for you. So we're going to enjoy this season of balance. And like I've been talking about, let's do 30 days to change a habit and take all of the fire that you have in your chart. Whenever you want to be one-sided, find the balance. Maybe it might not even be fire. It might be too much water. But wherever you tend to go to an extreme, let's bring the other side of that in. And let's use this month of Libra to just balance ourselves out. What a great time to do it as well. I'll see you back for TGI Friday tomorrow. Have a great Thursday. Bye-bye.